You just do it because you have to do it. When we say this, I want it to be in your heart that you are everything God has called you to be. You need to get that in your head and in your heart. Let it come out of your mouth. You got this? So say, this is my Bible. It's God's word to me. And I love it. Say, I am everything the Bible says I am. Say, I can do everything the Bible says I can do. And I can have everything the Bible says I can have. Say, I'm here today
on purpose
to receive the engrafted word of God to change my life.
And I
am being transformed
by the renewing,
not the removing of my mind.
Amen?
Are you there today? I'm glad you're here. This is a good day. This is a big day. I see we've got some people that have come to watch baby dedication. And that's okay. That's good. Because we're going to do the baby dedication, but I'm going to help your thinking. So a lot of times when it comes to baby dedication, I've had people come up to me and they say, well, Pastor, I've got this new baby. Do whatever it is you do with them. Christen them, baptize them, whatever it is you do. And they're thinking, whatever it is you do to make them holy, to make God love them, and make them obedient for the rest of their life. Now, I don't know about you, but that don't work. There's a lot of people, they think if I just get my kid baptized when they're a baby, then everything will be all right. And then you watch those people 20 years later and they're like nuts. And you think, well, that didn't work. And so what I want you to understand about baby dedication is this is not actually baby dedication. It's parent dedication. Because if we can get the parents to act like Christians at home. How many know there's a difference between Christians in church and Christians at home? You guys get to be the home guys. I'm sorry about that. But Christians in church, they tend to act one way. I like to call them parking lot miracles. And what a parking lot miracle is they are coming to church in their car, and they're cussing the traffic, the kids, each other. They're having a hellish time. But there's something magical that happens as soon as their toe touches the pavement in the parking lot. It's like, hallelujah, brothers and sisters, glory to God. Y'all following this? And then they come into church. Yes, brothers, oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And while they're in here, the devil and his demons are sitting on their car just waiting for them to come back so they can re-engage. And so they do the greeting thing. Oh, God bless you. What a wonder. You understand that most lies in church are told in the foyer. Pastor, that was an awesome sermon. Man, I love being here. And then they get to their car, and as soon as that last toe leaves the pavement, it all starts over again. And my thing with this that I would like everybody to understand is, now don't get mad, okay? Okay? Is most of your kids would be okay if we didn't have to send them home with you. Because the problem isn't what we do at church, and it's not the kids, it's what you don't do with them at home.
Amen.
Thank you, Spencer. So, one thing I want you to understand is that God has a plan for your children. Amen. And it may not be your plan. But you need to find out from God what His plan is. You need to find out what God has put in your child so that you can cooperate. Say cooperate. With God. And find out what He wants done with that child. What I watch is people who wanted to be a great tennis star and never made it out of high school. But now they got a baby. Tennis star. And their thinking is, I'm going to make this the tennis star and I will finally get fame. And I will be noticed as a tennis star baby's mother or father. And they have no idea what God called the kid to be. So they try to make the kid who God has called to be salt and light into a tennis star or whatever. Y'all follow me on this. It's not just tennis. It's whatever you're thinking. And so you have to make sure that you aren't trying to impose your what didn't happen to you in life onto your kids, but you're sticking with God and finding out, God, what do you want here? Are you out there? You following this? So the baby dedication, we're going to bring the babies up, but I'm going to tell you what, it's not going to do a bit of good to dedicate the babies unless we can get the parents to parent. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Thank you for those holy murmurs. That was good. So what I want you to understand is that baby dedication has nothing to do with water baptism. And neither one of those things has to do with God suddenly liking your child and deciding to make it a great child and it's never going to have any problems. Amen? The kid, no matter what we do to it, is going to have life come at it. And if you're the parent, your job is to train that child up in how to love God, how to honor God, how to serve God. Because if you don't do that, the world will train the child how to be. And you'll really be disappointed with what they turn out to be. And so this is, this is for the people who are not married. Who's not married? Good. See, that's, to me, there's hope in my heart. Did anybody over here raise your hand? Okay, see, there's hope in my heart. If I can get you to understand what this is all about, and I don't mean to be crude, but it ain't just about sex. Sex don't last that long, but kids do. I know that's a surprise to some of you. Like, what? Kids? But dedicating a child to God is very serious, and it's a very spiritual matter because we're going to incorporate vows that you, the parent, are going to speak over your children and over yourself. And God takes vows that are spoken to Him and committed to Him very seriously. Amen. Now, he's not going to do everything for you, but He will help you do what needs to be done. Amen. And so many times when people approach me, they want their child dedicated to God, even though their own lives represented an immoral lifestyle. It's church. We can talk this way. And the reason I bring that up is if you bring your child to church and you dedicate him and you do that, and then you think somehow magically you're going to go home and drink, cuss, and watch Netflix forever and never read your Bible and never talk about God, and somehow the kid is going to grow up okay, you're nuts. Because it don't work that way. The way it works is your children are going to imitate you. That could be bad or good. Usually bad. Amen. I said amen. But so many people think that there's something magical that's going to happen with God and their child if they do a religious thing. Dedication, that's got to be religious. Surely God's in that. How about if we kneel? Oh, that's religious. That don't mean squat unless your heart's in it. You know, and we're not into religion, we're into God. We're into Jesus. We're into the Word of God. We're into obeying God, learning, God, what do you have for me? What do you want me to do? How do you want me to do this? When do you want me to do this? And what do you want me to do with this kid? Are you out there? Because if you don't find out what God wants done and how He wants it done, you're going to be like almost all of the rest of the parents in the world where there's no daddy. And the kids haven't been trained. And mama's nuts because there's no daddy and she's having to do everything. And so the kids grow up and they're stupid. And all they know is Netflix, Facebook. What's the other ones the kids do? Yeah, see, they all know. Everybody knows. I didn't know. But whatever it is, and those things are presenting a picture to your kids of how to be cool. Well, I'm sorry, but I don't need my kids to know how to be world cool. I need my kids to know how to be God cool. I need to know, they need to know how to have a God life, how to honor God, how to love God, how to worship God, how to obey God, and how to serve God, and how to act like God, even in the car. So that they're not parking lot miracles, but they're everyday miracles. Yes. Are you following me? Yes. And so, you know, if you're not married yet, let me tell you something. Get prepared before you get kids. Because yes. I'm going to tell you what, when they wake up screaming at 2:00 in the morning, it's not easy to walk in love. No. After they poop on you, it's like, honey. Or you're holding them and they throw up down your throat, down your shirt. You know, it's like, that was fun. And you need to have a solid life. Get your stuff squared away before you get kids. But my main thing is if you're not married yet, you don't have kids, find out how to be a parent before, because afterward it is way too late. You will be drowned in throw up. Mm-hmm. And when you smell that way, it's not easy to pray. Amen. So ultimately, though there is a God consciousness in the parents, at least you're here. So you may not be perfect yet, but there's hope. Are you out there? You might already have kids, but there's hope. If you pay attention, praise God. And so I want you to, if you would, if you got a Bible, if you don't have one, steal somebody else's. Go to Deuteronomy chapter 6. Deuteronomy chapter, it's way back in the, turn left, it's way back in the front. And I want you to know something. God is not going to raise your children. He has instructed you to raise them in accordance with His Word. Are you out there? So I want you to understand this. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 6. I'm going to read this out of the New Living Translation. And so I want you to watch. Man, this is so good. I got excited. How many of you know it's good when you get excited about the Bible, about the Word of God? Anybody excited about the Word besides me?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. All right. Watch this. This is God talking to you. He says, you must commit yourself. In other words, he thinks this is pretty serious. This isn't some fly-by-night thing, maybe see how you like it. He says, you got to commit yourself wholeheartedly to these commands that I am giving you today. So he's asking you. He's telling you, you need to commit right now to what I'm about to tell you, if things are going to work right for you. And then verse 7, he says, repeat them again and again to your children. Talk about them when you are at home and when you are on the road. Did you hear me? Did you hear what the Bible said? God is giving us instruction for children, and he says, you got to get committed wholeheartedly to this. You need to forget tennis or knitting or whatever thing it is that's distracting you, your kids need you right now. And he says, you need to repeat it again. You know what I found out about people? Nothing personal, but we don't always get it the first time. In fact, most of us don't get it the fifth time. And your kids, they don't get it the first time. You need to repeat it and repeat it again and again. Talk about them. Talk about them when you are, God's word, when you are at home. What are you supposed to be doing at home? We watching, you know, Pokemon and Netflix. Well, you're stupid. You need to get some Bible in the house. And God should be first. And you need to repeat and repeat and talk to your kids over and over again and again. What does God say? What does God think? What does God expect? How does He want us to act? What does He want us to do? Are you out there? And when you're on the road, when you get in the car, this isn't the time to plug the kids into their earphones and put on the DVD thing. It's time to shut that stuff down and talk to your kids about God stuff. It's not time to space them out. Thank God. This may not relate to many people, but when I was a kid, we didn't even have a TV because they hadn't been invented yet. But I remember when, I think I was about 5 or 6 or something when we finally got a TV. And man, Mama loved to just plug us in front of that TV because now we were out of her hair. But how many of you know that's not God's way? God didn't say, y'all get a TV and put the kids in front of it and let them forget me. I mean, nowadays they got TV, Facebook, billboards with sex on them. I don't mean to be crude, but who would let their kids watch TV not knowing when the Viagra commercial is coming on? Do your kids really need that? I was watching a movie the other night. An old time, not an old time, but one of the last 30 years. I guess that's old time. And I was watching it, and I'd watched it several times before. I enjoyed it. I can't remember the name of it. And all of a sudden, they're using the F word and cussing, and I'm like, I didn't see the uncensored one. And I just had to turn it off because I don't need that in me. Did you hear what I'm saying? Listen, if you don't need it in you, your kids don't need it. Because when they hear that kind of vulgarity, that language, it makes an impact on them, and they get used to it. And the more used to it they get, then the more they start using it. Are you out there? It's our job to protect our children from the world, not help them become more like the world. Are you following me here? Because the world's idea... I mean, I was just thinking about this. It has a little bit to do with it. But when I was in college, we used to smoke dope on a regular basis when we weren't drinking on a regular basis. And I was just thinking about this. None of the people that I smoked dope with were very bright. And as we smoked dope, they did not get brighter. And a lot of them today, they're the guys you see in the tie-dyed t-shirt with the long gray hair and the little headband, and they're still stoned. And the world system is to get your kids stoned on the world. Every place they look, there's a billboard of something they don't need. On Facebook, there's something they don't need. on wherever it is they're looking. It's a bunch of stuff. Who's supposed to be putting the right stuff in? You are. Are you out there? I heard a story of a little girl years ago that her family brought her up as Christians, and they brought them up the way I'm trying to teach, the way I've taught. And she, you know, if your children are brought up right, they're taught to honor you, to respect you, to love you, honor, respect, and love God. And they become so much of they're not alienated from the family. They are, that's my family. That's the way your kids should be. They should be, that's my family. I'm a Boyer. This is Brian Boyer right here. I'm not a Boyer, but this is how his kids should think. And this little girl, she was at school one day, and some of the kids after school, they said, let's go have a cigarette. And I'll just use his name because, yeah. And she just looked at him. She says, "Us Boyers, we don't do that." Amen. Did you follow that? Your family needs to be so tight with each other. You don't beat your kids into submission. They need a spanking every once in a while. But they're not alienated because you still love them. And you respect them and you honor them. And so they become, you know, there's a lot of other names that they're a part of the family, but they're not really a part of the family. They're trying to get away from the family. But your family should be the kind, this is a good family right here. What's your last name? What is it?
Ewing.
Ewing. The Ewings are a great family. Cheris is one of our worship people, been with us a long time. She's got two babies now. But I could hear Cheris if somebody said, "Let's go do some dope," and she'd go, "I'm a Ewing. We don't do that." And your kids should be able to say, I'm a Belisa. We don't do that. Amen. Well, let's go smoke some dope. Are you kidding? I'm a Roberts. We don't do that. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Not, well, us Christians don't do it. No, what are you getting in the family? Does your family, is there that kind of love and confidence and solidity that your kids can say, no, us Ewings, we don't do stuff like that. Let's go rob a store. Ewings don't do that.
Amen.
Are you watching me here? Because that's the kind of thing you need to be portraying for your kids. Well, I'll just bring them on Sunday. Sunday for an hour and a half ain't going to do them a squat. Did a bit of difference if they have to get in the car with you while you cuss at them all the way home. And then you go home and smoke dope, drug, alcohol, cuss, watch lewdness. And then you're wondering, how come my kids don't obey? Well, they're watching you. How come my kids aren't good kids? They're just like you. Yeah, but I took them to church. Big deal. You ever hear of Judas? Best teacher he was with? Closest friend he was with? And he still went wrong. Why? Whatever was taught to him when he was a kid was unfaithfulness. Are y'all out there? Y'all okay? Please say yes. So, repeat them again and again to your children. Talk to them when you are at home, when you're on the road, when you are going to bed, and when you're getting up. Man, that's a full-time deal. You almost don't have time for Netflix. Thank God. Or whatever stupid thing people are doing now. Yeah, but everybody does it. Well, they're going to hell. You want to go too? You want your kids to go? No, I had them baptized. That don't mean squat. There is no such thing as baptize them and they go to heaven. There's no such thing as baby dedication and they go to heaven. They still have to live a life committed to Christ. They still have to choose Christ. They still have to live for Christ. It's not a, well, I already did that. Now it's back to being me. Are you stupid? Don't be stupid. Ephesians chapter 6. Y'all okay?
Yep.
You're doing really good, by the way. Ephesians 6, verse 4 says this. Watch this. Man, this is so good. For fathers. Ephesians 6, I see pages still turning. It's back towards the right. If you can't find it, forget it. You'll never find it. I can see it. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger by the way you treat them. Rather, bring them up with discipline and instruction. How many of you know you can bring your kids up with discipline and instruction without being mean about it? But when you're ignorant, there's only a couple of ways you can rule. And the number one way is fear. Don't try to rule by fear. Get smart and rule with wisdom. So he says, by the way you treat them, rather bring them up with the discipline and instruction that comes from the Lord. How many know God holds parents responsible to bring up their children and discipline them and instruct them in the Lord? Are you out there? God expects you and I, with our kids, that we bring them up, we instruct them, we discipline them, we love them, we help them. They are not going to, one of the craziest things is I watch people come to church for like 10 years and they still don't have a relationship with Christ. If you asked them, they would say they do, but you can tell there's no light, they don't. Because in order to have a real live relationship with Christ, you have to spend time with God, you have to hear God, and then you have to obey. And the biggest thing I see is, and it's not just this society has been going on for thousands of years, people don't like to obey. They love information. But what they love more than information is not doing anything with it. And God wants us to learn and do something with what we've got. And he expects us to get from the scriptures how to deal with our children. Proverbs 22:6. Y'all ready for this one? Are you there? Turn to Proverbs 22:6. I want to make sure you're there. I want to make a point. Y'all okay? Yeah. Hallelujah. Okay, Proverbs 22:6. Are you ready? Yeah. God will train up your child in the way he should go. The angels will train up your child. Oh, Jesus will come to your house and train your child. I like these guys over here. The Holy Spirit will come in and train your kids. What's it say? It says, and the implication is, you train up your children. Is that right? It doesn't say, you just hand them to me and I'll take care of them. It says, you train up your child in the way he should go or she should go. And when he or she is old, he will not depart from that way. And the sad thing is if you don't train them, they will not depart from that way either. And I've only been in the ministry since 1984, so I'm kind of new at this. But the one thing that I'm always depressed, I was going to say impressed, but I'm going to say depressed, is how many people, 30, 40, 50, 60 years old, 70 years old, are still fighting the things that they had to deal with when they were kids and haven't gotten over it. They're still trying to figure out, why am I no good? Because somebody told you when you were a kid you were no good and you believed it and you've lived with it. Because somebody told you you were stupid, because somebody told you you couldn't, And instead of you getting your mind renewed to the Word of God, you keep believing that stuff and acting on it and dealing with it. And it's a constant problem. And you can never become who you are supposed to be until you deal with who you are and get rid of that. Yeah. And your kids won't either. Are you out there? So, like I said, this doesn't mean that you train them up in the way you want them to go. It means you train them up in the way God wants them to go, right? I said, right? So, if you're going to train them up in the way God wants them to go, then you've got to stay close to God. You young people that aren't married yet, you need to develop a relationship with God that's a daily thing now. Because when diapers come and throw up comes and binkies flop out, you're not going to have time to start some new regulations and rules. You better have them down pat. Yes. Amen. Especially the 2 o'clock in the morning. Wah! Yeah. Oh, God. And so, you know, the billboard things and the Facebook things, and your kids are subjected to all kinds of stuff. At school, when they're driving down the road, you need to make sure their minds are stuck on God. Are you out there? Amen. And so, what I want you to understand is that when we dedicate, whatever we do, there's no magic make my kids do right wand. They're going to do and act however you teach them, however you show them. You don't even have to teach them at home. You just be you and you're teaching them. Because kids do not listen to anything you say, but they watch everything you do. And they become exactly who you are. And the kicker about being a kid is you look at your parents and you think, man, they are stupid. I'm never going to do that. Then you grow up and do it. And that's even more stupid. Are you out there? So we receive words to live by, and then we are responsible to live by them with the Lord's help. Amen. All right? And there, and I've said this before, but if, and this is for the people who don't have kids yet, there's very little help, if any, value in dedicating a child if the parents are not Christians and serving God. Amen. Amen. If you would, hopefully, did y'all get a piece of paper? Did everybody get a piece of paper that says new creation, children learn what they live? Would you get that out? If you didn't get one, raise your hand, we'll get you one. Whoa, Shonda, Shuma, Shuma. You moved to Lincoln City, you don't get one. Amen. Why don't you go ahead and get the parents out here? Hello? The parents? What? That's what I said. Go get them. What?
Tell them to go get their children.
Oh. Okay. If you have kids that are going to be dedicated, please go get them at this time, and please don't get somebody else's kids. Unless you like them better than yours. But if you're going to do that, go get your kids. Hallelujah. Now listen to me. Baby dedication, somebody keep that kid quiet. That's Cheris, by the way. You don't have to leave. Get in here. Baby dedication or water baptism do not take the place of godly parenting, okay? Amen. I want you to get that. I want you to understand that. You can't just, here, God, they're yours. He's like, no, they're yours. I gave them to you, and you have the responsibility to train them up. You following that? So, I love this. This is, you all got the piece of paper? I want to go through this because this is how life is. If a child lives with criticism, they learn to condemn. If a child lives with hostility, they learn to fight. If a child lives with ridicule, they learn to be shy. If a child lives with shame, they learn to feel guilty. If a child lives with tolerance, they learn to be patient. If a child lives with encouragement, they learn confidence. If a child lives with praise, they learn to appreciate. If a child lives with fairness, they learn justice. If a child lives with security, they learn to have faith. If a child lives with approval, they learn to like themselves. If a child lives with acceptance and friendship, they learn to find love in the world. And I don't know if I've ever heard truer words spoken, because I watch so many people who are shy, insecure, and I know where they've come from. When they were kids, somebody didn't parent them quite right. And generally that person needed help too. But when I got into this God thing, everybody in my family that I've ever known has been divorced at least once and remarried 50 times. That's an exaggeration. Most of them were alcoholics. Most of us, all we knew how to do was fight with our marriage partners. And when I got born again, when I got filled with the Holy Spirit, I had to make a decision. I'm cutting that off. Yeah. Well, you had a heritage curse. I don't care what it is. I cut it off in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Got into the Word of God and found out how I was supposed to talk, how I was supposed to act, and just began doing what God said to do. I could go back and say, well, I didn't have proper training. Nobody diaper trained me right. What a bunch of garbage. Grow up. Quit making excuses for the way you are. Get into the Word of God. Accept it as truth. And do what the Bible says to do and watch your life change. But on the better part, watch your kids finally get a break at having a good chance at life. Because this whole thing should be about your kids getting a decent break so they don't have to grow up with the garbage that you and I grew up with. I don't care how you are, how you have been, how your family's going, you can cut it off in the name of Jesus and just begin doing what the Bible says and change your whole family. My family, for me, my wife and my kids, is totally different from all the rest of my family for hundreds of years because of Jesus, because of the Word of God, the Holy Spirit. Are you out there? So we're going to have the parents come up with the babies, hopefully. Y'all come on in.
Okay, so I will begin to call the child's name, so mom and dad.